let's wait, because you're not going to get there in time anyway. Although, no, we should probably just get them now. Because I want to send them there as soon as possible. Guys, I think he's done it. Yeah. What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to Basement. I'm your host, the Bourbon Otis Falcon. Yes, we're in my Steam page here at the moment. We're here because, check this out, Basement Chapter 3, November 15. Today's November 16. It dropped yesterday. Which is kind of weird because the first two, story chapters dropped on the 31st. So basically in 2 weeks, they released the third episode. That's amazing. Now check this out, though. Before we jump in, the reason why we're not in game right to start off with is because of this. Okay, here is level 3, the Hui Zhao story. That's probably not how you pronounce that. It's a bit buggy, a little too hard, and contains tons of inappropriate lexicon. So, we're gonna go in there and give it a try, but apparently it's a bit too buggy and a bit too hard. So, hopefully we can beat it. If not, then hey, at least we're gonna check out chapter number 3. Now, keep in mind, I have recorded a video for us before this, me doing the sandbox. Because it is sudden update, I'm gonna release that video after this one, but I recorded it before this one. So, when I release that one, it'll be asking you guys if you want to see a sandbox run until the next update comes out, which dropped here. So, you know, it's kind of really weird time travel stuff, but just whenever you see that video, just understand that I recorded it before this one. Let's jump into the game. Alrighty, so we're back in game here, and here it is. Hui Xiao's restaurants, a mutually beneficial arrangement. I wonder what's so buggy or hard about this. I guess we'll find out. Maybe you get attacked too quickly. Perhaps, who knows. So here we are. Gunther shouldn't die and Kenny shouldn't die. Oh, really? No kidding. They shouldn't, but if they do, eh, you know, it happens. So, can we call this guy like an easier name? I'm gonna call this guy DMX. Is that good? X gonna give it to you? So, DMX got into some financial problems and has agreed to work with us while he digs himself out of the hole. In a month, he needs to pay $11,000 to his investor, or he'll lose all his restaurants. We'll supply DMX with the goods, selling them is his problem. Yes, sell no problem, but no protect me and my restaurants. No one... What? No one in the ass? What are you taking in the ass? Why? Yeah, you pick up a load every 3 days. The first batch is ready. That's right, 3 days. I bring you money and pick up load. Cool. Let's get cooking, Kenny. We got a lot of work to do. Now, the gangs are busy with each other, and they've not paid attention to us. Let's take advantage of the situation, don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
Don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
So this might just be a matter of producing quick enough, huh? Okay. Oh wow. So it just seems that all we're doing here is producing. Now, knowing the game, it'll probably switch something up on us event some point or another. But at least for now, all we're doing is producing. And they will allegedly leave us alone. Tasties. The Sensitive Squid Eyes Restaurant. Yeah, more than likely, the gang's gonna probably are the reason why this has become difficult. Maybe they'll start pushing in on the restaurants or something. Or maybe they'll eventually attack us too, who knows. Gunther shouldn't die. Save up 11,000. We got a month for that. And then 15, make a batch for DMX. I warned you not to mess with me, Tupo. I'm gonna lay some track up on your ass. Oh, Miguel, I can just taste you crackers. Okay, they're over there fighting, at least it has nothing to do with me. Let's see, so we got 7 more batches to do in apparently 2 days, which is fine. New room upgrades are available, a new employee is available. Well, we don't have a locker. Yeah, these guys are attacking each other over here. We don't have a locker for us to hire anybody else. Not that we can anyway. I mean, we can because we don't have a freaking locker. They're driving by? Look at them driving by over there too. Get them! Coming out of this area, huh? Well, let's see how much money we're at. 377. We're gonna easily have the batch for DMX here pretty soon. I'm curious if we could upgrade this to some degree. Do we want to upgrade it? We don't have enough power for it. Well, I was about to hopefully upgrade that, but let's see. Wasn't it a cool idea to get the gangsters against each other? Yeah, and I figured that we should start working with DMX. Yeah, that's cool too. What's up with the delivery, by the way? Are we gonna make it in time?
Oh yeah, we already got enough for that. I said 2 days. We're good.
Alright, so we got Miguel's gang running... who's gonna win? Oh! Tuco's gang came through. And now Tuco's gang's sending an attack on Miguel here. Wonder who's gonna win that. Alright, can we up... Oh no. Oh no. This is probably where it gets difficult. You done it in the restaurant business with MFing Japanese Frankenstein. He's not Japanese, Miguel. That's very, very insensitive. I'm pretty sure he's Chinese. Except all this crap is on my territory, so you're just gonna have to...
No, you don't F me. This restaurant not belong to you.
Oh, now Tuple's involved too.
You're both mistaken. These restaurants are in my territory, so grab your crackers and get on out of here.
Tupo, you SOB, I'll destroy you.
No, it is I who I would destroy you, Miguel.
Can you imagine, like, gangsters talking this way?
No, it is I who will destroy you.
Essay?
We need to keep them from capturing our restaurant.
Oh, what'd I tell you? Green is go. Oh no, he's coming here? Now?
But how am I supposed to keep them from...
They're coming now, too!
Okay, but who's supposed to come over here?
They're not gonna survive that. I can't send these guys.
I don't have a locker to hire people.
This is a terrible situation, I would say. Alright, hold up. Power, first and foremost, can we get this power upgrade? We can do +4 electricity. I'm gonna buy that momentarily. We already have the badge for DMX. I missed, dude, Chinese guy, he was saying something.
Yeah, that must be the worst, Kenny. We need to retake that restaurant.
How? Hit the gang at the understanding squid's eye. Green captured, yeah, I know they did.
So, do we have to move in somewhere and pick up a locker? Like, go to the old Roach Motel and...
Can we build a locker here? What if we got rid of this here? Can we get rid of this? I guess. Build. Locker. Okay. How many dudes are there? 3? It's not really the big hulking guys too, which I guess is kind of a small silver lining. I just realized though, how the hell do I make money at this one? Because we're not selling it. Oh, we could probably have to wait for Homeboy to show up. Want to give us some dough?
While Tupo and Miguel are at war, they're sending fighters to beat each other up. Sometimes it's better to wait until several fighters leaving a building you want to take. If you wait for the right moment, it'll be a lot easier to grab the building. But keep an eye on the clock.
Yeah, so this is probably why this becomes difficult, because you gotta time everything really, really good. There's a lot of dudes there, right? A lot of dudes there. That's technically ours. And we got a batch here. Okay, so we got 1100 from that one. Come back in 3 days for a new package. Right. So let's really quickly...
Oh, we can't hire people who have enough room.
So if I fired one of the dudes and it's just me and Kenny producing, would that be enough? I'm curious about this because, yeah, we already have enough. I mean, we're doing pretty good. As a matter of fact, we got 3 days. All right, I'm gonna fire Javier. I can't even hire anybody. I gotta upgrade this thing first to hire somebody. Okay, upgraded. Hire somebody now. The problem is sending only one person at a time to attack isn't really gonna get us done for us here. We need to send two at least, but let's get Woodrow in here. It's an amazing name for a freaking thug, by the way. Woodrow. Okay,
I need to get this back, don't I? But by myself, I don't like it by myself.
We'll just send bodies after bodies, at least for now. They're gonna, oh no! They all went to the bottom floor, so they're basically gang up on this dude. Like, we could have basically taken the guy up top. If we at least brought one of them down, I'm okay. I'm fine with that. We already have enough marijuana for homeboy. I'm almost considering selling this, getting another locker momentarily. Of course, we gotta hire these people, which is, you know, costing us money. So, in the entire premise of the thing that we're doing, we gotta send dudes, we gotta pay them to take care of the guys, but then we're losing money and we're not selling any dough, or we're not sending any weed ourselves. So, unfortunately, we have to wait only until DMX gives us money, but that's in 2 days. I don't like it too much. And unfortunately, here we go. We got two. Three. Oh, I didn't even take one of them out. That sucks so much. Choose attack. Yeah, I have a feeling we'll probably fail this one. I need to kind of like find the right meta for this one. Like what I should be focusing on right now. I'm kind of all over the place. Like, I'm not sure if I should be removing things or not. I'm getting lockers up or not. So we took that now. Welcome to the sensitive squid. Thank you. We back in business. Now you go out of my restaurant or all your fighter will... No, they won't. Sodomy? No, it's not sodomy. Why would they do that? Kenny, we need to send all of our fighters away from the restaurant. Now that we have captured the building, we don't need fighters anymore because we don't have any more work for them. Don't just stand around expecting us to pay them, so stay safe money. I know about that. Unless we need to go grab something else. It always makes better business sense to send them fighters somewhere else instead of just firing them. Yeah, like as in before they die, right? I mean, they're technically almost dead, though. So choose, return home before they kick you out. Where do we send them? Very good question. That's one of our restaurants. Too many dudes there. I guess we could go there. Abandoned laundry. A lot of weekend dudes over there, too, huh? If we could get enough money, we could probably take this one. There's a lot of injured guys there. You saved my restaurant. Beautiful. We're back in business. I'll see you for the next batch. How about some money momentarily? No, there's a couple of strong dudes, but there's a couple of them quite weak. Oh, there's a lot of them there. You know what? Just go there to die. Hey, if you knock out like maybe two, it's fine. This big guy is the one who worries me. Now, we got 433 left over. We don't have to pay each other, so that's the good part here. We can still probably get two more goons. We should probably send two goons together along with these guys at the same time, huh? Strength in numbers. But anyway, we should get a payment from DMX here pretty soon. They're off to attack somebody as well. Yeah, they went down. But we brought two of them down. Not too bad. Two are weakened, three are weakened, and then four weakened. This is not impossible. I'm not sure this is how you're supposed to win this level, but I'm finding a way. 156 for Tony. 174 for Deborah. I wish we had enough for three. I think three would have been really, really good for us. We'll send these two, and then... Oh, they got two more dudes. That's the problem. That's the freaking big problem. Okay, hold up. Let's see what they're doing over here. Maybe we take over this one instead. Maybe. Just maybe. Don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
Don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
We gotta be really fast about it. But just maybe. Forget that one. They spawned a couple more. If we could get paid, we're gonna get paid really soon, actually. If we get paid, we'll get more goons, send them off over here, and I think we should be fine. Here's a new badge for you, thank you. Give me the money. Come back in 3 days. Yeah. Higher. Well, let's wait, because you're not gonna get there in time anyway. Although, no, we should probably just get them now. Because I want to send them there as soon as possible. Guys, I think he's done it. Yeah. Looks like all you crackers boys, now I'm coming for your cheese balls. Why did you do it? I warned you, didn't I?
Don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
Don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
Oh. Oh.
Don't attack them?
But which one did you want me to attack then?
Did I misconstrue that information? I think I probably did then, huh? Because I was under the impression like, hey, you know, it's probably the best time to send them after a wave has been sent out because there's less people guarding it at that time. Oh boy. We're about to get... Let's be honest here, we're about to get raw dogged.
Okay, please keep me safe. That's fine. As a matter of fact, Tony, get out of there. Get out of there as soon as possible. Here they come, as I expected. Hey, yo, we're... No! No!
Don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
Don't mess with them, and they'll leave us alone.
How many numbers was that? Dude, they said way too many.
No, Kenny, I died.
I feel like there's a South Park joke somewhere in here.
Damn, dude. Now you're gonna have to start the level over from the beginning.
I like how he's dead, but he still was able to let him know, hey, by the way, I died. Just FYI.
Wait, that's it.
Load a checkpoint? Is there a checkpoint before? Oh.
It's day number one. That's not a couple of days. That's the entire freaking level.
All right, boys. We failed. Alrighty, well, either way, I'm going to take a look at this one off camera a bit more closer. Could we have won had I not attacked Tuco?
Maybe, possibly. I'm not really sure if we were even, like, going fine in our own little, I guess, lane if we were going there.
We were keeping up with the supplies that we had to give out. But I'm still curious about, like, whether we're going to attack another restaurant. More than likely, they probably would have. I wonder if what I messed up on is not attack them at all, as they mentioned that I shouldn't do. But what they probably meant is that they'll probably take over restaurants as the challenge goes on. But what we got to do is send goons to reclaim the restaurants we lose almost immediately after they took over a restaurant. Because that's basically when they're at their weakest state. So it could possibly be that, and not just, hey, go attack them straight out like I, for some reason, thought that we had a good chance. I mean, we took over that freaking base, but apparently they sent the entire freaking mafia after us. Or the cartel, because I think Tuco's Mexican, not really Italian. But either way, we'll wrap it up here. I'm going to take a look at this off camera a bit more closer, see what the strat for this level is, and we'll give it another attempt later. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I will catch you next time.